I've been using AI tools to create content for a while now, and honestly, it's been a bit of a mess. I'd have one tool for generating images, another for making videos, and before I knew it, I was paying for way too many subscriptions every month. But recently I found Pollo AI, and it's actually solved most of these problems. You get every best-in-class AI tool all in one place. It's basically like having a complete creative studio in your browser. You can generate images, create videos, edit everything, and even maintain consistent characters all in one place. In this video, I'll show you exactly how Pollo works and why it might replace half the tools you're paying for right now. All right, a huge thanks to Pollo AI for sponsoring today's video and making this deep dive possible. The first link in the description will take you straight to their site. From there, just create a free account or sign in to get started. Once you're logged in, you'll see the main dashboard with several key sections. The interface is organized into different creative workflows, and the first thing you'll notice is a few main options: AI video, AI image, and AI avatar. You also have other filters and the explore page, which is perfect for getting inspiration and seeing what's possible with the platform. Let's start with image generation. For that, click on the AI image option on the left. This is what you'll see. We have text to image and image to image. Then under features, you can chat with the image to make edits directly. You also have Laura, Canvas, and a few other tools that give you more control over your creations. Let's pick the option text to image. Click on it, and here you will see this interface. First, we have a model selection dropdown where you can see all of the popular models. So we have the latest NanoBanana, which is currently unlimited on Pollo AI for subscription users. We also have Midjourney, which you won't see available anywhere else, but you get it here. You'll also see all the Flux models, Google Imagen 4, ChatGPT image model, and other major options. Now, I'm curious about Midjourney, so let's select that model and see how it performs. I'll use this prompt here, which I took directly from Midjourney itself. Now, we also have the option to select a style. Here, you'll find a wide range of pre-made styles that you can instantly apply to your prompt to enhance the final output. Next, we need to choose the aspect ratio. For this example, let's go with 16:9. And now, finally, let's hit Create. And here's the result. As you can see, the image quality and aesthetics are exactly what you'd expect from Midjourney. So, if you don't want to pay separately for Midjourney, you can access it right here alongside the other models. Alright, to really understand how these models perform and which one does better, I ran a series of comparisons between the top models across multiple prompts and scenarios. Let's look at the results, and then we'll pick a winner. The first test I did was portrait photography, and these are the results I got with this prompt. Overall, all of the models followed the prompt fairly well, but at first glance, the Midjourney image looks the most realistic. The fine texture on her face and lips is clearly visible, and the overall color balance looks excellent. Next, we have NanoBanana and Imagen 4. Both of these also produced realistic images, but the skin texture isn't quite as detailed when compared to Midjourney. Then there's Flux Context and ChatGPT Image. Unfortunately, neither of these results looked very realistic. In the ChatGPT image output, the woman appears much older than intended, and the overall aesthetic feels poor. With Flux Context, the skin looks plasticky, with an unnatural shine or glow that makes it feel even more AI-generated. So, in this test, the best model for realistic portrait photography is Midjourney, followed by NanoBanana and Imagen 4. The next test is for cinematic results. I used the same prompt across all of these models, and here are the outputs. First, we have Midjourney and NanoBanana. Both of them turned out really well, and I got the grainy, slightly blurry texture I had included in the prompt. However, Midjourney edges ahead just a bit. The colors feel richer, and the overall elements look more balanced. Next are the results from Imagen 4 and Flux Context. Both produced unique styles. Flux gave us a darker, more grainy aesthetic, while Imagen 4 delivered more detail in the environment. You can clearly see the complex structure of the buildings, the bench, and even the wires. Both came out pretty solid, each with their own style. Finally, we have the ChatGPT image result. This one didn't perform well. It's overly dark and almost all of the detail is missing. So, in this cinematic test, most of the models did fairly well, but my choice for the winner is Midjourney, because it holds the most complete cinematic look overall. Alright, the next test I did was for text accuracy, and here are the results. Starting with ChatGPT Image and Imagen 4, I have to say, ChatGPT is currently the best model when it comes to text accuracy and overall design quality. Imagen 4 also produced some good results, but across 6 to 10 test images, I faced a few consistency issues. Next, we have Flux Context and NanoBanana. Both were able to generate correct text, but I only got clean results after 2 or 3 attempts, so consistency was a bit hit or miss. And finally, there's Midjourney. As expected, Midjourney still struggles with text, and the results just aren't reliable in this area. So, for this test, the clear winner is ChatGPT Image, which gave me the most accurate and usable results on the very first try. And finally, I tried this prompt to test how well each model can generate fingers correctly. This is always a tough challenge for AI, but surprisingly, ChatGPT once again did a great job in this test. It really understands the prompt and gives you the correct results almost every time. Other models like NanoBanana and Imagen 4 can also deliver good outputs, but usually after 2 or 3 tries. Finally, Flux Context and Midjourney struggled here. They just couldn't generate accurate fingers. So now you've got the idea. Midjourney is still the best for overall aesthetics, while ChatGPT is the strongest for prompt adherence. NanoBanana stands out for editing images, which is exactly what we'll look at next. All right, if you click on the image-to-image model, you can start editing images with NanoBanana. And right now, you can use it unlimited, without the watermark you usually get in the Gemini app. To claim this benefit, you just need to be on any of the paid plans. In the model selection, simply choose NanoBanana, and you'll get the option to upload up to 8 images at once. So let's start by uploading this image of a man holding a pistol. I used a prompt to replace the pistol with a banana and also remove the rose. And here's the result. Now he's holding a banana, the rose is gone, and everything else in the image stayed exactly the same. NanoBanana also does a great job with text editing. For example, in this menu board image, I prompted it to replace the word cappuccino with matcha latte. And in the result, it swapped the text very neatly without altering anything else, which I found really impressive. You can also take a desaturated image and simply prompt, colorize the image with natural lighting and skin tones. NanoBanana will instantly bring it to life with realistic colors. You can also create product photography with NanoBanana. For example, I used this Red Bull can image along with a few simple prompts I got from ChatGPT, and the results were stunning. NanoBanana generated these cinematic product shots that look super aesthetic. And the best part is, you can create them without even touching a camera. Pretty cool, right? And it doesn't stop there. If you have a character image, you can use NanoBanana to make your character hold the product in different scenarios. I tried this myself, and the results came out really great. Realistic, creative, and versatile. You should definitely give this a try in Pollo AI, since it's free here and doesn't include the Gemini watermark. Alright, now let's explore the AI video feature and compare all the AI models to find out which one is the best. Click on the AI video option here, and you'll see two options: image to video and text to video. Since image to video is often more useful than text to video, we'll try that here. Now, if you click on the model selection dropdown, you'll see almost all the major models available, including some of the best ones like Hilo 2, Kling, Veo 3, and Seedance. To test these models, I used multiple images with each model to see which could animate better. So the first test I did was the rain effect. I used an image of a taxi driving on a rainy night to see if these models could generate a realistic rain effect. And this is the first result from Hilo 2 model. The rain effect here isn't very realistic. It falls correctly, but it doesn't look convincing on the car or the road surface. Next, we have Kling AI. This one performed better. The water on the road and the splashes look good, and the rain effect itself is decent, though still not perfectly realistic. Then I tested Seedance 1 Pro. The rain is falling smoothly and the animation looks good, but strangely it doesn't fall on the car's body at all, which feels unnatural. Finally, we have Veo 3. In this result, the rain falls nicely, even on the car's roof, but not on the side panels, which again breaks the realism. It seems like the rain effect is still a challenging task for AI tools overall, but out of all the tests, I'd say the best result came from Kling AI, which handled the effect slightly better than the others. So, for the second test, I used this image of a medieval castle to see how realistically each model could demolish a structure. The first output is from Hailuo AI, and I have to say this one really amazed me. The effect looked very realistic. The castle broke down naturally, and you could even see dust rising in the air. Next is Kling AI. For me, the animation here looked messy, rushed, and not realistic at all in terms of detail. The third result is from Seedance 1 Pro, and this one was much better. The physics of the building falling were handled more accurately, and overall it looked fairly realistic. Finally, we have VO3. In this test, the animations weren't very realistic. I saw a similar issue to Kling, and the quality overall was quite poor. So, for this demolition test, the clear winner is Hailuo AI, thanks to its realistic physics and natural-looking motion. Okay, so another test I did was with camera motion. I used an image of a girl and prompted the models to zoom in on her face, capture her emotions, and then show her turning back and running. The first result is from Hailuo AI, and I was very impressed here. The camera motion looked cinematic, and the way she turned back and started running felt realistic and fluid. Next is Kling AI, which also did a great job. The motion was smooth, it captured her emotions well, and the running sequence looked natural. Very impressive overall. Then we have Seedance 1 Pro. It followed the prompt correctly, but the motion could have been more dynamic. It just didn't feel as engaging as the first two. And finally, we tested VO3. While the camera motion itself was decent, the overall quality of the video wasn't on the same level as the others. So in this test, all of the tools did fairly well with camera motion, but if I had to pick one winner, it would be Hailuo AI, thanks to its very dynamic and fluid movement. All right, now Pollo AI also has an avatar feature. If you click on the avatar option on the left, you'll see an interface with lots of AI avatars. All you have to do is upload an image and a script, and you'll be able to create these talking avatars. And finally, if you click on Pro Effects, you'll see a variety of trending effects that you can try out for fun. For example, we have Earth Zoom, which is really popular these days, and Action Figure, which is also going viral. If you scroll down, you'll find even more unique effects to explore. So let's test the action figure effect. Click on it, and you'll see this interface with two options. You can hover over them to preview the demo videos. Now, I'll upload this image of a puppy here, and that's it. All you need to do is click on Create, and the tool handles everything for you. Okay, so this is how it looks. And as you can see, the action figure of the puppy looks exactly like it does in the image. Here's another version, and both of these were really fun to create. Now, if you click on this button, you'll see a menu with all the other effects you can apply in just one click. For example, this one is the Earth Zoom In effect, where the Earth zooms into your uploaded image. I also tried the hug effect. You just upload an image of two people and the AI makes them hug. All of these effects are really fun to use and you should definitely give them a try. So that's all for this exploration of Pollo AI. Check the first link in the description and try Pollo AI for yourself. Start creating with all the AI tools you need, all in one place. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button, and if you're new here, please consider subscribing to the channel.